I've got the power. This is the Yumi Digi Power. It's a 6.3-inch Android phone with Android Pie, but it also has a 5150 milliamp hour battery, which is insane. So if you want to be playing with power, then stick around because it's Tech Quiz time. Hey guys, Jonathan here with Tech Quiz Time, where I create technology tutorial and review videos. In this video, I'm going to be looking at the Yumi Digi Power. So like I've mentioned already before, it is a 6.3-inch 4G mobile phone, smartphone, with Android 9 or Android Pie installed on it. So it's the latest version at the time of filming this video. Actually, one thing that I want to do is I want to just disclose quickly, Yumi Digi did actually send this phone out to me. It is a little bit late because I've had so much to do at the moment and I'm getting prepared for something huge. So in saying that, this was sent out by Yumi Digi. They haven't asked me to do anything in particular except for to review this phone. They haven't paid me for it. So all the thoughts and opinions in this video are my own. So with that out of the way, let's keep going with the video. So the biggest selling point with this mobile phone is its huge battery life, and that's got a 5150 milliamp hour battery. Now that's massive in terms of size of the actual battery itself. A lot of phones out there, they will have a 3000 milliamp hour battery, some of them even smaller, some of them a little bit bigger, but generally this will get you almost 2 days, if not more if you're a light user, of use out of this phone. Now that's massive. Like, that means you don't have to charge it. I mean, it's been sitting with me for quite some time. I haven't even bothered to charge it and it's still got 19% there, so that's just sitting there doing nothing. And I think it's been sitting there for well over a week without any charge. So if you're sold on that already, yeah, that's definitely one of its biggest features. Now the screen resolution is 2340 by 1080. And you'll see here that the camera cutout is just on top. So they call it a water drop bezel, or the notch for most. So it's got USB-C charging and that's at 18 watts. And it also features NFC, which is one of those things that definitely I'm looking at with my mobile phones whenever I'm looking at a new one. Having the ability to load my cards in there and not have to take my wallet with me is such a huge time saver. Trying to find where I left that wallet, yeah. When you've just got to take your phone with you, it's so much easier. So the front-facing camera that I mentioned there before is a 16 megapixel camera. The rear is a dual camera at f1.8, so to give you that nice blurry background, or as blurry as you can get it on a phone at least. The two cameras are 16 megapixels and 5 megapixels. So your primary is 16 megapixels, of course. So just touching quickly back on the battery again, it's got a standby time of 471 hours. That's why this thing has been sitting there without any charge and it's still got 19 hours left. That's massive. So pretty much that equates to about 9 hours worth of gaming full time. So if you've got a big commute, then this phone is definitely for you. So the processor this phone uses is the Helio P35, and it also comes with 4 gigabytes of RAM and a 64 gigabyte inbuilt storage. The phone itself comes in either black or gold, and it also comes with this really nice looking faux leather sort of case, which I really like. Most of the ones you get the plastic cover, but this one, yeah, it just feels a little bit more premium. So nice job, Yumi Digi. So like most of the Chinese smartphones, you get a dual SIM slot there, or you've got a SIM slot with the micro SD card slot as well. And that supports up to 256 gigabyte micro SD card. So it supports Bluetooth 4.2 and also all your Wi-Fi is up to AC. So you shouldn't have a problem connecting to this device or connecting to a Wi-Fi network at least. All right, so let's get into the benchmarks. So I ran some Geekbench benchmarks, some Antutu, and also 3DMark. So when it came to Geekbench, the single core score came in at 916, and the multi-core score came in at 3,922. Moving over to Antutu, we've got a total score of 84,320. Broken down, we've got a CPU score of 40,264, a GPU score of 12,859, a UX score of 24,158, and a memory score of 7,039. Now, when it came to 3D Mark, the two tests that I ran were Slingshot and Ice Storm Extreme. So in Slingshot, we got a score of 721, and in Ice Storm Extreme, we got a score of 8,144. Now, a lot of you might be asking, what are these scores relevant to, and what do they mean to me, or you, I should say? And what they mean is that if you've got your current phone there, you can download this software, the Geekbench software, the Antutu software, or the 3D Mark software, and test this out on your phone just to see how much more powerful it is. And then also compare, when I play games in a second, how it runs these games compared to the Yumi DigiPower. Now, the other thing you've got to take into account as well is that this phone itself is worth less than $200. So you've got to take that into account and think, okay, well, is it worth that? You know, when you're spending X amount on a Samsung Galaxy S10, that yeah, it's going to blow it out of the water, but for a sub $200 phone, that's a pretty incredible price. So when it came to gaming, most games are going to work on this fine. You're not going to have too much of an issue. The games that I like to test out are emulation, and in particular, the thing that really will push this is the PlayStation Portable Emulator, or PPSSPP. And I just lost my blue background light. I promise future videos will be more organized. I've got it back, the blue light's back. Don't stress, everyone. It's all right. Okay, so like I was saying, I've got to get back to my train of thought now. But yeah, PlayStation Portable really does push Android devices. You've got other ones out there like the PlayStation 2 emulators and so forth that really, really push it, and GameCube. But PlayStation Portable, I like to see how God of War works on it in particular. And the other one is Power Stone. So I'm going to throw them up on the screen now, and while I'm just talking over the top of them, you'll see how God of War actually performs. Now, just keep in mind, God of War is a pretty difficult game for most phones to run. So unless you've got a more powerful mid to high end range phone, you're not going to get 60 frames per second out of God of War. And Power Stone, it runs on most lower end devices anyway, so it's not too bad, but it's definitely not the performance you're going to get out of a massive phone that's worth, you know, almost a grand. So keeping that in mind, what do I think of the Yumi DigiPower? Well, for a budget smartphone that you're going to spend like $150 to $170 on, depending on where you buy it from, it's not a bad phone. If battery life is something that you're really craving for, then this phone could really fill that craving spot for you. And with any luck, you enjoyed that musical number that I gave you right at the very start. So in saying that, links for this product is down in the description below, where you can check it out and see what the prices are like at the moment. So thanks again for watching this video. I really hope you liked it. If you did, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit the notification icon, so that way you get notified whenever I release a new video. If it's something that you think other people are going to enjoy, then definitely share it on social media platforms like Reddit, Facebook, Twitter, all the usual places. And once again, I just want to say thanks for watching this video. And as always, imagine, learn, create.